I've spoken a lot about the importance of electrolytes and specifically sodium on my channel, and I know this causes confusion for a lot of people. There's this misconception out there that salt is bad for our hearts, that it raises our blood pressure. And I've done videos addressing this in the past and talking about it, talking about how salt and sodium do not cause hypertension. Yes, consuming salt can temporarily raise our blood pressure, but this isn't a bad thing. Exercise is another example of something that raises our blood pressure, but it's not bad. It raises it temporarily, but over the long term, it helps to keep it within a healthy range. But anyways, in today's video, I wanted to do a bit of an experiment and test out what would happen if I doubled my salt intake for a week. I'm going to measure my blood pressure, and then I'm also just gonna keep track of my energy, my mood, my exercise performance, etc. And if this goes how I predict it's gonna go, show you guys how salt can actually benefit your health rather than hinder it. And we'll talk a little bit more about this as we go through the video. Now, usually I add an electrolyte supplement to all of the water that I drink. I usually use Sodi's Everyday Hydration Salts because not only do these contain a good amount of sodium, they have 1000 milligrams per serve, but also potassium and magnesium as well. So based on what I usually consume, I'm gonna try to aim for about 5,000 to 7,000 milligrams of sodium a day, which is well above what the Australian dietary guidelines recommend. But I'm basing this goal off of Dr. James D. Nicolantonio's recommendation. He's a cardiovascular researcher and also the author of the book, The Salt Fix. This is how much he recommends consuming every day if you work out. His recommendations for someone who's a bit more sedentary are slightly lower, 3,000 to 5,000 milligrams, but I usually do some form of exercise every single day. I go on lots of walks, so I'm going to shoot for that higher range. And basically, I'm just gonna double what I usually consume and see how I go. Like I said, I am going to measure my blood pressure. I'm gonna do that right now and see where I'm at, and then I'm going to see what it's at after I drink my water bottle with soda in it. So it's just after 7 a.m. right now, and my blood pressure is 118 over 73. So within the healthy range. So as we get into this, let's talk about why salt and sodium, more specifically, is essential and not an option. Sodium literally is an essential nutrient. We need to get it in through our diet. It plays an important role in regulating the fluids in our body and nerve and muscle function. This is why when you're low in sodium, you can experience muscle cramps. This happens a lot when people are exercising and they become dehydrated. It's actually due to a lack of sodium. Now, if your sodium levels are chronically low, this can cause dehydration, this can increase your heart rate, and this can also increase stress hormones. And here's an anecdote relating to heart rate from my experience. Alcohol, as most people probably know, dehydrates you. And a large part of why you feel hungover the following day is because you're dehydrated and because you're low in electrolytes, including sodium. Now, I've noticed that whenever I do a workout, following a night when I've had a few drinks, my heart rate is a little bit higher than it normally would. Sometimes it's actually more than a little bit higher. And it's harder to control, and it's higher because you're dehydrated and because of low electrolytes. This is what I've noticed personally, and it makes sense. Anyways, on that note, I'm going to have a bit more water before I go, with electrolytes, of course, maybe have an espresso shot, and head to the gym. So I'm back from my workout. That was actually a really good class. I'll put my heart rate data from that workout here, and then I'll put my heart rate data from a similar workout where I had a few drinks the night before, and you guys can see the difference. So you should be able to see that I was able to bring my heart rate down in between sets on this one today, and not so much in this one, and I think a large part of that is having enough sodium and being properly hydrated. I also felt really good in today's workout. I felt like I could push myself a little bit further, which makes sense because, as I mentioned earlier, sodium is important for nerve and muscle function. Anyways, I am going to go test my blood pressure again. So let's see what that's at. So there was a slight increase in my blood pressure again after my workout. But as I said earlier, that is entirely to be expected. Basically, when your muscles are working as hard as they are during a workout, they need more oxygen, there needs to be more blood flow, and that's why blood pressure increases, but this is temporary. Over the long term, exercise only benefits blood pressure. Now, another reason why I think that a lot of people in my community need to be more mindful and prioritize their sodium consumption is because they've cut processed food out of their diet. And processed food, it is absolutely loaded with sodium. So when you're eating the standard American, the standard Australian diet that has a lot of processed food, that has fast food, packaged food, all of that, you don't really have to think about how much sodium you're getting because you're getting a lot of it. But when you switch to eating mainly whole foods, which I know a lot of you have done, you need to add in the sodium because there isn't going to be as much in your food. So yes, salting your food, that helps, but supplementing is really, really important, especially if you're eating a lower carbohydrate diet, because when you're eating lower carbs, your body retains less electrolytes, so you need to replenish them more. People who are just starting low-carb diets often experience what is referred to as the keto flu, which includes headaches, fatigue, sometimes nausea and digestive distress. And a lot of these symptoms are actually from electrolytes being low because your body's retaining less of them. So that's why you really need to make sure you're prioritizing them, especially when you're first getting started with a diet change. Anyways, I've been feeling pretty good today. I am probably just going to fill up my water bottle, drink some more electrolytes, get some work done, maybe go for a walk in a little bit, and get some fresh air, some vitamin D. I'll catch up with you guys a little bit later. Good morning, guys. So it's the next day. I actually slept really, really well last night, which I don't know if that had to do with the sodium or not, but either way, I'll take it. Maisie is just going crazy. What are you doing? Oh, meow. Anyways, I think I probably had around 6,000 milligrams of sodium yesterday from the electrolyte supplement and from salting my food. I'm just about to get dressed. I'll have my electrolytes and I'll probably make a coffee and put some MCT oil in it. Now, if you guys are coffee drinkers, that is another reason why you want to really prioritize your salt intake. Coffee is a diuretic. You probably know that, so it means that it dehydrates you, which means that you just need more electrolytes. Just one cup of coffee can cause the body to lose about 400 milligrams of sodium, so you want to make sure you're replenishing them. And this loss of sodium is part of the reason why some people can start to feel jittery if they have too much coffee. Now, I always make sure to hydrate before I drink my coffee in the morning. So like I showed you yesterday, I drink my full water bottle. I think it's about 750 milliliters, usually with one packet of soda in it, but I doubled up yesterday. But when I do this, I know that I'm replenishing the electrolytes that I'm gonna be losing. Another question that I wanted to address is if you can have too much salt. And the answer is no. Our bodies have mechanisms in place so that we excrete sodium if we have too much of it, but if we don't have enough, they have to kind of work in overdrive to recycle and reabsorb what is already in our system. So it's better to overshoot your salt consumption than to undershoot it. And usually if you're having salt cravings, this is a sign that you need to consume more. If you're eating something and it tastes really, really salty, to the point where you don't really want to eat it anymore, then that's a sign that you've probably had enough salt. Now, my blood pressure at the start of yesterday and at the end of yesterday was exactly where it needed to be, under 120 over 80. I haven't tested it yet this morning, so I'll do that in a second. But if you guys are still a little bit unsure about consuming too much salt, I highly recommend the book, The Salt Fix, which I mentioned earlier in the video. I'll put the link to check it out in the description box down below, but that basically just outlines the importance of salt and all the misconceptions that surround salt and how most of us are not consuming enough of it, especially, like I said, if we're eating a whole food, low carb diet. Again, it's an essential mineral. We need to get it through our diets. And it's kind of funny to me. I think I've mentioned this before in some of my videos about salt, but drinks that are marketed at athletes, things like Gatorade and whatnot, the whole purpose of them is that they have electrolytes and that electrolytes are really important. But it's just ironic that we're still told to limit certain electrolytes and how they've, salt specifically and sodium, how it's gotten blamed for heart disease, for hypertension, when really the bad guy is the processed food, is the excess sugar, is the highly refined carbs. All of these are loaded with sodium, but the sodium's not the problem. All right, guys, so I've reached the end of my week-long experiment, and I just wanted to give you a bit of a recap. Overall, I've felt really good. My energy's been on point. I've been sleeping well. I haven't had too many cravings or like excessive hunger or anything like that. In general, I've felt pretty focused. My mood has been pretty stable. And my blood pressure, as I've shown you a few times, it's been normal in the mornings and in the evenings. The only times it's been a little bit elevated have been after exercise and immediately after I drink electrolytes. But as I said, this is to be expected. Now, if you feel like you are experiencing some of the side effects of low electrolytes, if you are someone who drinks a lot of water and you don't add anything to it, if you've been exercising a lot or you live in a warm climate, if you've cut processed food out of your diet, and especially if you've lowered your carb intake, you probably need more salt. And that's where I would recommend adding an electrolyte supplement into your routine, such as sodi. Now, I like sodi because it doesn't contain any added sugar like you're gonna get from some of the sports drinks and other electrolyte supplements, and it actually contains a good amount of electrolytes. Some other options on the market, you're just really not getting enough sodium, so it's a little bit pointless. Sodi's hydration salts contain the perfect balance of electrolytes for everyday use, and they actually taste delicious. They aren't super salty tasting. I don't know how they do that, but somehow they just taste really, really good. Right now, I've been loving their new pineapple flavor and their new grapefruit flavor, but honestly, all of them are good. They ship worldwide, so if you wanna check them out, I'm gonna put the link in the description box down below, and you can use code KATE15 at checkout to save 15% off your order. I hope you guys found this video helpful, and I will see you next time. Bye.